It pretty much starts and you're running.
Welcome back to the stream, everyone. So, one of our rare weekend streams. So, let's see, we got plates and coal and cogs coming down here. I just got an achievement. Awesome.
Oh, shit.
One turret is engaged with the enemy. Okay, we just got our first attack.
I'm still loading it. Hot damn.
Let's see. How do I shoot my gun again?
Is it C? I think C and hover your mouse over what you're trying to shoot.
Oh, God. This is taking forever for me to load in.
That's weird because yeah, you should be loaded in. I think I saw the... Was that?
Takes me a while, too.
Let's see.
Weird, though. I thought I saw it say Tanuki was sending the save file to him.
How do I grab stuff off the conveyor again?
F.
I'm at 45%.
Oh, loading the game itself?
It says checking sprites, 46%.
Yeah, I was stuck there for a while. I was stuck on sprites for a while, and once I was past that, it loaded pretty quick.
What is this, and why is it damaged?
Oh, was that the thing that got attacked?
A damaged belt here?
Yeah.
I'm standing next to it.
Really? I don't know why. That's what it looks like. It's damaged.
Yeah, there'll be a little bar that that shows when stuff is damaged. Okay, first things first, I need... I feel like this belt is going to be less... Well, hang on, what's our pollution looking like? Yeah, that belt is not as critical as northern defenses. There we go. Mr. Tanuki is downloading the map.
Yeah.
There we go. Weird. Thought I saw three people pop up for that, but I guess not. Now, one thing I will say is, at least early game, the more iron you guys can give me, the better I can keep us alive.
Okay, I'll get more being made.
Sounds good. Because I'm gonna need to basically fill up all, keep everything full with ammo.
Okay.
Also, for the record, I normally remain unarmed myself. I do normally any bullets I manufacture go straight to the turrets. So if I personally get jumped, I am screwed. Okay, heavy armor looks like it finished.
Yeah, I'm looking at what the hell we can do.
Sounds good. At this point, as far as weapons and stuff go, basic ammo should keep us pretty good for at least a while.
I'm working on getting what the hell. I need to work on getting. Let's go with fast inserters.
Those can be handy. We'll definitely want those later. So.
I'm working on trying to get up a factory for green, which is going to take an unholy level of shit.
It will be nice once we get to the point where we're doing laser turrets. The only catch with laser turrets is that they are ridiculously power hungry. So one thing I was wondering is, and I think I remember this getting discussed last time we played, but I don't remember if we came to a conclusion. One thing that I commonly do in my games where I have the aliens turned on is that I will actually build like an artificial peninsula out into, say, this large lake up here and effectively have like there's only one way on or off, and it's kind of also doubles as a kill zone with turrets and stuff. It's basically the only way you're going to be able to fully defend a base with laser turrets. If people want, I can kind of get started on that.
Might not be bad.
Sounds good. The one thing we will need for that, and there's no major rush on this, but the one thing we will need for that would be... Do we need green science? Yeah, okay, we need green science for landfill.
I'm working on getting green science up and running. It hurts my brain.
Yep. Basically, the big part of the reason that I do that is that when I play Factorio, I tend to play very long games. And you will eventually get to the point where we can't hold this area. At least not without, like... Actually, could I... Okay, I could maybe hold that peninsula, but I would not be able to hold this entire base kind of a thing.
All right, so this...
Eventually, like, right now, all that are attacking us are small aliens. There's medium, large, and behemoth.
So this box right here should have ammo in it.
Excellent. Thanks. There's another box of ammo to the right there. Or there's another factory that'll produce ammo to the right there.
Okay. I suppose I could start just, like, belting it to some of these.
Yeah, it's probably not a bad plan.
What was it? What button opens up the menu for crafting?
For crafting or research? Crafting?
Crafting.
E.
That's the one I wanted.
And it always throws me off that in Terraria it's something else.
Okay.
Actually, so it throws me off any game where it's something else. I'm going to start breaking down some of these like big rocks here just because I will eventually need... I'm eventually going to need thousands or tens of thousands of stone to make landfill.
Okay.
I'll be back in a second.
Sounds good.
Actually, let me finish what I was doing real quick.
Transporter needs... Okay, I need iron plates and... Iron plates and iron gears for that.
Just refilling some of our burner stuff with wood.
Yeah. Okay, now I'll be right back.
All right.
We get some of the-
And regular inserter. Okay, so I need... How do I make electronic circuits?
Electronic circuits are three copper wires and one iron plate.
Good lord. I'm trying to figure out how the fuck to make a factory that makes green.
Yep. There's a noticeable step up in complexity going from red to green, and there's a notable step up in complexity when you go from making green to making blue. Blue, you start actually needing to do oil production. I would personally say oil production is the most most complex part of the game. In some ways it's actually kind of fun, but I would say it's the most like complicated piece.
Yeah.
Okay, what am I doing? I'm just kind of flailing around here. Why is this damaged? Do we have stuff that's actually making it past these turrets into our base? I don't think we do, but...
Okay, so you are supposed to be doing green. I need something that... I need two more factories. Let's work on that. Wait, no, I need three factories.
Yep. One thing I will say with green circuits... It is impossible to produce too many green circuits. Basically, we're going to need tons and tons and tons and tons of those for so many other things throughout the game. Like, for example, it is not uncommon for me to have a factory that produces 10,000 of them a minute, and it still can't keep up.
Trying to think about the positioning of this shit.
We have a... Where's the nearest stone deposit? Oh, that's down here. I need to drop some turrets down here, actually. Because I don't have that protected at all.
Now, do I want to use more electrical inserters or burners?
Generally speaking, you want to move to electrical as fast as you can. Just, it's more convenient, and also, sooner or later, you start running out of things to shovel into your burner inserters.
Yeah.
Like, right now, we're using trees. Sooner or later, we're going to run it. Well, we could be using coal and things like that, but technically, it's also more efficient to use electric.
Oh, incoming.
From the north?
Yep. They're dead.
Yep.
Right through here.
Okay. That seems to kind of be their most common way of attacking. At some point, we're going to want to go up and deal with those.
Mm-hmm.
That's much more... Cernobyl is the expert in that. I am more in the base defense area.
Okay, I could shovel those onto here.
I'm going to go ahead and just manually reload some of these quick.
Got two burners set up. Actually, I need to move that pole. How do I get rid of it?
What was that?
How do I get rid of a pole?
Hold right click on it. It's basically how you unbuild anything.
I'm going to have to do this in two shot. Thank you.
And one nice thing that the game does is kind of a thoughtful touch. Anything that holds stuff, chests or stuff like that, it actually makes you hold E a slightly longer to destroy those, because it really, really, really sucks when you accidentally delete a chest. Ask me how I know.
How do you know?
I've done it. It sucked. Can confirm. Do not recommend.
I need an assembling machine, and that's a buttload of fucking plates.
Again. You know what? I'm actually going to move these two turrets down here on the south end of our mining area. I'm actually going to move those further down and put them next to the stone mining area, because anything that attacks from the south, that's where it's going to attack first. I find the hardest part with base defense is not actually so much defending your base as it's defending your mining outposts. That always seems to be like the challenge. All right, fast inserters are done.
Oh God, I am working here on getting freaking green going, and it's a bitch.
One thing I'll do a lot of times, if I know that I'm just working on something and don't necessarily need a certain tech right away, is that I'll actually just deliberately choose one that's going to take longer, just so that I don't have to start changing it as often.
I'm just picking at this point.
Yep, and stone wall is honestly a good one. It's one of those games, there's tons of different ways you can play it, and there are tons of different strategies people play with.
And I need more scorpions.
Pole keeps backing up. I know we're piping it over there, but I might need to switch things around for a new chest or empty the hell out of it.
Well, the other thing too is, so far So far, we have our coal going, you know, being sent up basically to our manufacturing area. One thing that we could be doing, actually, it looks like we have coal and iron gears. One thing that you can do is we could actually route all of our, iron plates, copper plates, coal. We could actually belt all of that stuff up there.
I actually was just like yoinking about 400 plates because I'm going to need a shitload. I need to make like, I think, 3 factories if my brain is working right, and I doubt it is.
I'm back.
Welcome back. Actually, you probably do need to make, you're trying to make inserters?
Okay. I'm trying to figure out, I need to make green. I need to make belts, which I think is going to take 1 factory.
Belts do take 1, assuming you already have gear wheels, which you will.
And then inserters are going to need to take 2. It's going to be a 2-step because I need to make circuits.
Actually, it's going to be 3. Because you need to make copper, wire, then you need to make circuits, then you need to make inserters. You're going to need a ton of copper wire over the course of the game, too, so.
Weapon shooting speed, that's just weapons, yes, okay, whatever.
Sounds good.
Go there. Okay, that's... First things first, I want to make 1 factory for now. Make the factory. Okay, assembling machine.
We have iron gear wheels in the ammo belt up here.
Yeah, don't worry about that.
All right.
I was trying something. Wasn't the greatest.
Didn't work.
I mean, it technically worked, but. Okay,
I have made 2 new factories piping into another one. Yes, this is messier than shit, and I can't select a recipe for assembling.
Your first factory always will be.
You are going to be... I need belts. The top one is going to be belts. Fuck it. Okay, your belts. Your empty belts will be then taken and put into this one, which is the factory for the green. Going backwards, you are going to be the inserters. I now need 3 things.
Just going through and cleaning up some stone because, like I said, I will need probably tens of thousands of it. So the way I normally do it, as far as the like offshore artificial peninsula, is that I kind of usually take the attitude of it's nice to defend mining outposts, and you hope to try and defend your mining outposts, but to me, the main factory on the peninsula, that's the piece of this absolutely cannot fall. So I tend to put most of my effort toward having a fully independent power grid just to run the turrets and like actually completely isolated from the main factory power. But when we get to that point, I'll deal with building that. But... That's something I usually do.
My brain just kind of went, what?
Yeah, basically it's the even if our factory runs out of power, the eventual laser turrets that line the path onto and off of that artificial peninsula, those turrets cannot like run out of power. So usually I build a completely separate power system for those, but You guys won't need to worry about that once we unlock solar, because I always like to do that as solar power. I can take care of that.
So you are going to be, you are my, you build this. Okay, I need something for, copper wire was the first thing I need. Copper. Okay. Next, electric circuits. Okay. I have the factory set up. God, this thing is ugly.
As any first factory should be.
It's a mess of inserters, power lines, and machines.
Good.
I'm going to need a belt from one of the factories to the lab. But whatever. I don't fucking care.
All right, so let's see. We can now make fast and filter inserters. Filter inserters.
Now I need to start getting materials up there to this shit because, oh, God.
Yep.
Okay, this chest is starting to overflow. Why do I have bullets in my shit chest?
Why do you? That's a very good question.
There was a moment where I was like trying to get stuff together, and I'm like, hey, can I merge these two to save on some belts? Answered not well.
All right, I'll snag those and put them someplace where they'll do some good, and then
okay, let's start using up some coal here. Kick more
can
coal.
Can somebody come over to where I'm at and fix the electricity? Because it's kind of a hot mess.
Yep, I'm on the way.
Let's see.
Or you got it?
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah, I just kind of, my brain is kind of not 100% yet from the plague.
Yep, no worries.
It's all working, so I don't know what they're...
Yeah, it is working, but it's just a lot of power lines.
Yeah.
We can probably minimize.
Oh, you should see the factory I'm building up there. It is all hot. Fucking mess.
You call that a mess? Wait until you see an actual mess. We're still early game.
Put that there, and can I take this one down now? Yes, okay. That cleans it up
normally, a bit. Normally, like, even at work, I am meticulously freaking organized with my shit.
Yep.
Something I'm building or doing looking like that is honestly a what is wrong with me.
Yep.
My problem is I can't freaking think because I've been working 12 hours and it has not been an easy week.
Yeah, I hear you there.
My brain is legit fried. Come on, hurry up. Okay. First things first. Let's see if this works. Start building copper wiring.
I'm just going to dump this in over here just so these turrets over here get filled because... In the event we get an attack from the southeast, I want to make sure that it doesn't take us completely by surprise.
It works, as tragic as it is.
Step one, make it work. Step two, make it work better. Step three, repeat step two.
So, question. Do the inserters only really move when the factory is out?
Moves when it gets low, yeah.
Because right now it's only loading up to build one pack.
Yep. Yeah, usually what will happen is that it tries not to let itself completely run out, it doesn't like pull full stacks in or anything like that. I say it tries to not let itself run out. Later game, when you start dealing with things that speed the machines up, you can get to the point where the assembly machine for the circuits, for example, you can get to the point where it's building a circuit instead of building a circuit at the normal speed, it's building a circuit like 10 times as fast as normal. And then you start running into one inserter can't keep this thing fed fast enough. By the way, you'll notice that a lot of our machines are running kind of slow and stuff here.
Mm-hmm.
If you hover over them, you can see that the electricity is either yellow or in some cases red. Mm-hmm. Basically, what that means, if you click on one of the just any of the power lines, you can see our power grid. And right now we're producing about half, actually we're producing a little bit less than half of the power that our machines would like to have.
Yeah, I want to figure out a way to jack that up.
A couple ways we could do it. We could either A, extend a like pipe, like a water pipe here, set up a second boiler and a second steam engine. Or we could, actually pretty much that's our only option until we get solar.
Okay, I got some more stuff for stone set up.
Thought we had.
Yay. We do have stone set up. We're just gonna need a lot of it.
Yeah, I added like two or three. I added like three more.
I thought we had solar. No.
Nope. We have optics. We have like one of the prerequisites for solar, but we don't have solar yet.
We can research solar.
Yep. Solar requires green science, and it's actually what does it require? 250. Just going from memory. Am I right?
Yeah, 250. Shot.
I have way too many hours in this game. But the downside with that is that it does take a long time to research. I might lean toward trying to get landfill first, just because then we can start building that little peninsula thing. But that's just me. People can do what they like.
I was thinking we build solar so we can build an Armageddon laser and completely just remove the aliens from existence. I mean, what?
The closest you can get to that would be artillery, which is basically a giant cannon. It's a load of fun, but the only downside with it is that basically it will mostly level a base, but then everything that was in that base all charges at once, which actually can be a lot of fun as long as your defenses can handle it. Mm-hmm.
Okay, looking at the stuff we have, or have available for the tech tree. You need landfill, and that's not that bad.
Yep.
Advanced material processing gives us better something we needed.
Better furnaces.
Okay, let's see. So...
can we research two things at once or only one?
Only one at once.
Fuck muffin.
But both of those are pretty fast researches. As long as we can keep the assembly machine stocked. Also, since our machines only have a little bit less than half the power that they wish they had, that also means our factory is running a little bit less than half as fast as it wants to. So if we can actually get more power up and running, actually I can take care of that.
That's actually what I wanted to do, is solve the grid problem so we can get shit running better.
I can solve that pretty quick.
Actually, can...
I will do this. Let's see, is there a convenient place for this? Yeah, kinda. I'll take it. Okay, I just tripled the amount of power we have available. That should last us for a little while.
Holy shit, what the fuck?
Basically, I just set up a double steam engine setup.
I was waiting for you to do it up there, and I'm like...
Oh, there wasn't much room up here without extending belts and things like that. So to keep that uncluttered, I just kind of built it along here for now.
Okay, yeah, I see.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, these machines are still not.
What is they're green bars, so they have full power. But if you hover over them, for example, like hovering over the belt machine, you can see how it says output full. Basically, what that means is this machine can't actually output anymore to the green science machine. And actually, if you look at the green science machine, it says the same thing. So basically, all of these machines are pretty much at the point now where
I see the problem. It needs a chest.
Well, actually, you can either do it as a chest, or you can do like we have down here, where it just uses an inserter. So what you can do is you can have an inserter from here to like a single piece of belt, and then you can have an inserter from that single piece of belt into the lab.
Sure.
Or you can do it with a chest. Some people do it with what are called people call them buffer chests. Some people do buffer chests, some people don't.
Okay, so I want the arrow going towards the lab.
Yep.
And I want the arrow going towards here with...
What are you now, doing? One thing I would suggest before placing that inserter out of the Green Science Factory, put the thing there where it's going to go to, either a belt or a chest. Because otherwise what happens is, while you're building that, it's just dumping stuff onto the ground.
Why are you not going the place I want you to?
What are you trying to do?
I might have a small problem.
Oh.
This pole might be in the way.
Oh, that's easy enough to move.
Yeah. I just didn't want to.
That's fair. Moving power poles gets much more dangerous when your factory gets much larger, because then you start running into like, oh wait, that was also powering my turrets.
Yeah, like I just moved one that was powering something else.
Yep, yeah, it was powering this inserter. The nice thing is that especially small power poles are dirt cheap to make. So it doesn't hurt. It doesn't actually hurt anything to have too many power poles. It just is visual clutter, and it can take up a little bit more space.
I might need
All right, let's see how things are going up here.
So far, right. So good.
No,
I will point out that this coal here is backed up all the way to the mines. So
yep, which isn't a bad thing.
I hate it. I keep stealing the coal because I hate it.
You hate that it's backed up like that?
Yes.
It being backed up like that is actually a good thing, because it means that our minds are keeping up with what we need.
Okay. Why is this thing not actually stealing? Did I aim this the wrong way?
Look at this top inserter. Yep. By the way, one thing you can do once something's already been placed, if you hover over it and hit R, it'll rotate it without disassembling it. And it looks like this needs to go down one more space for this to be able to reach.
The lab is right here. It's like...
Yeah, but you see where the belt is? Basically, the belt needs to come down one more. It just barely can't reach the inserter just barely can't reach it to grab it.
So do I put another belt there?
Yep, you can just put another belt right where... Yep, perfect. Okay. One thing... Have we unlocked the... Okay, so we have unlocked... There's those red inserters. This isn't necessarily the place you'd want to use them, but we have red, what are called long-handed inserters.
Yeah.
Those basically, instead of going from like right here to right here, those go from two spaces one direction to two spaces the other direction. Okay. Which there are times where that can be really helpful. I don't use them a lot, but there are things they're really good for.
Okay. I'm not using any green science because right now we're researching shooting speed because I needed something.
Yep. So what will eventually happen is that this machine will fill this belt, and then this machine will get full, and then all these other machines will get full.
Yeah.
And then there's basically they're fully ready to go when we start researching something that uses green science.
Like landfill is my next one that I want to do.
Sounds good. Yep, we just got attacked again. By the way, if you haven't noticed yet, when we get attacked, there's that little yellow alert icon that flashes down in the like bottom of the screen. If that's yellow, that means we're getting attacked, but none of our stuff is taking damage from the attack. If we get red icons, that means that stuff of ours is actually taking damage. And if we see a red X icon, that means stuff of ours actually is getting destroyed. So yellow icons are normal. Red icons are hopefully not normal. If those are normal, we have a problem.
Yoink. Okay, that should declog things for just a little bit. Yoinking. There. Let's get things moving a little bit. Okay, I think I'm going to make myself a weapon to fight back with.
All right.
Because I have this pistol, but that ain't going to do shit, right?
It's pretty effective against, like the beginning dudes, but, you'll definitely want something bigger as time goes on, and eventually we will build a tank.
Like a shotgun would be good.
A shotgun would be good.
Cause you were talking about eradicating the hostile menace up there.
Yep. That first base, by the way, just a little, side note. The game, also for viewers, the game does generate chunks beyond what you can see, and it always generates enough chunks that that basically there always are aliens just past the edge of the screen. So theoretically, you could fully eradicate all the aliens on the map if you explore the entire map. I don't. What was that?
Mac 59, thanks for the suggestion there. So I should really do that. So,
yeah. What was your suggestion?
That I should place the new ones before I remove the old ones, and then I won't have stuff all over the place. And let's see.
But having stuff all over the place is a time-honored tradition.
Yep.
Yep. Actually, since you're already doing
that, and we have making, aren't you inserting? It's not full, so I should be inserting stuff. I suppose I could shorten this entire thing. That filter one here. Do it quick. I guess it's just nothing to worry about. So,
okay.
What I am seeing is that we have a bunch of copper plates that are needed, but not. So.
Yeah, I have a hot stack here that I've just kind of plug in as
the. Okay, so
I'm removing one of the ammo belts that I have down here because, actually, I don't think I'm going to set up a turret wall here.
Okay.
At least for the time being.
Okay.
Why isn't my underground thing not working?
White, isn't it networking?
I know it's a bit of a mess, but we're kind of tight on space.
Yep. Well, yeah. Let me take a look here.
Because I ate it.
Yeah, it looks
nom, 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 nom.
Belts. Okay, underground. Oh, right here?
Yeah.
Okay, so right now, the one that I'm standing on right here, basically, you see how the this is basically like if it was coming out of the ground here.
Okay, can you fix it for me?
Yep, I can do that. Also, I think this might be too long, but let's take a look. Know what I wanted? Okay. Okay, this is slightly too long. So what we can do is, if we make this an underground one, basically we can scooch this closer, and then it's going to be able to go underneath.
Okay, I'll watch you do that.
All right, 1 second here.
Still recovering from the plague, so my brain is...
Yep, no worries.
At, you know, point... 001 cylinders.
And I'll just belt this off.
Yeah, I just wanted to get some more copper made.
Yep. Eventually, we'll unlock better belts that not only go faster, but the underground portions can reach longer. Which, honestly, I find just as useful as the extra speed.
Okay, so I have cleared up a little bit of space. I've created a box that is nothing but coal up here.
Yeah, I've got a box along the side that's nothing but copper.
Okay, let's see. We got
coal bags. I was gonna go get some plates.
I almost want to start using some more coal just because we have so much.
Tanuki, I'm going to dump some plates into the machines up here.
Okay, yeah, go ahead. I'm just grabbing some plates for personal use. Because I have a
problem. What you do with your plates is your business.
Once I find the iron plate box, grab a couple stacks. Okay. First thing I wanted to do is build another lab. So, I'm building another lab.
Makes sense.
I want to. So,
did we ever find any oil patches? I don't think we found
any. We found have one.
Like one tiny little itty bitty thing surrounded by alien butt nuggets.
Trying to remember where that was.
It was up on the islands north of the peninsula.
Oh, I see it. Okay.
Okay, so...
basically, for as long as we're using steam, oil is actually really nice because with oil you can make what are called fuel blocks. And so, so what'll happen is... over time, the coal patches will get depleted and the trees will get depleted. And like, you know, whatever else we use, it'll eventually run out. Oil doesn't fully run out in this game. It'll slow down to like, you know, a small trickle of what it started as, but it never fully runs out. So basically, you get a undepletable fuel source that you can use to power steam engines and stuff without... without worrying about things like, oh no, our coal ran out.
There. I have now started up a second lab, which I'm hand feeding, but whatever, that is now helping our research. So hopefully this weapon storage thing goes by a little quicker.
Weapon storage? Oh, the shooting speed?
Yeah.
Another thing that we can do too is there is, so right now we've researched automation, which is what gave us these assembly machines. Mm-hmm. There's also automation 2, which will give us faster assembly machines, and automation 3.
Oh no, help, fix it.
What's going on?
I messed something.
No
worries.
I took this mine down because it was out of resources.
Okay.
So. Yep.
All right, let's see. How do I want to move it now? We will put you here.
Just to confirm, is this belt intended to be aimed up here, or?
The heck's going on?
No, that's...
It's a...
No.
All right, let me... One downside with how easy it is to rotate things just by hitting R is that a lot of times you'll accidentally rotate things you don't intend to.
automation 2. There we go.
Yep. As to what, as to where that is priority wise, that's up to you, but.
Well, I know you wanted landfill as soon as possible.
Yeah. Landfill is kind of like my top priority. After that, somewhere along the way, solar power would be nice, as would laser turrets, but, those are lower priority, I feel.
Solar power is in my, I want it.
Yeah.
Because pollution triggers these things hardcore.
Well, the hard part is, and I feel I should warn you on this, solar power in and of itself does give you solar panels. It does not give you batteries. So basically overnight, they're not producing any power. But there is another technology that you will eventually research that gives you effectively batteries.
I know we wanted better, I think, smelters. What does advanced processing give us?
Advanced material processing gives us steel furnaces, which are still ones you have to put fuel into, like our stone furnaces, but they're more efficient and they're also twice as fast.
I know we wanted those. And then there is automation 2.
Yep. It's one of those things, there really are no bad technologies. Like, it's kind of like a, we want everything, it's just how important is each thing.
All right. You're still going, you're still going, you're still going.
Now, the downside is when we increased our power like this, let's see, steam engines do produce, actually, do steam engines produce pollution or not? I think steam engines don't directly produce pollution, but it means like all of our machines that do produce it, you know, always a good idea to kind of keep an eye on how much we're producing.
Yeah.
We're going to start getting more attacks from the north. And then also, we're not terribly far from starting to get attacks from the south either, I think.
Yep.
Well, it looks like that shotgun's looking really good, so making that quick.
Yep. And I mean, especially like, you know, now that we're getting kind of established, if people want to kind of go on the offensive, you absolutely can.
I'm waiting for cars and guns.
Tiff.
And then somebody can drive me around when I can, so I can shoot things.
Another fun thing you can do, although this is usually more of a mid-late game thing, eventually you can build power armor that is so good that it's way better than the tank. But the tank, it does have a certain amount of fun to it.
Oh, yeah, right now I'm just building some shotgun shells and I'm arming up a little. You know, once you start getting attacks, how do I shoot my gun?
It's holding down C while hovering over what you want to shoot at. I think there is another button that lets you just sort of free fire, but I don't know. You're damaging our stuff here.
Yeah, don't worry about that.
This factory got damaged.
Yep.
What happened?
You damaged some of our stuff.
I made sure I knew how to fire my gun.
Ah.
I needed a target.
Are you the hunter safety instructor?
And, I
was standing by that tree you were shooting at, too. I just want to point out.
Yeah, you'll notice how have you taken damage?
I haven't.
Okay.
So. But I noticed that like, you know, health bars started appearing around me, and I was very concerned.
Now, how do we...
One thing that you can build, and actually I'm going to build right now, is... under the production tab, the top thing that's like a screwdriver and a wrench as a repair pack. And that's what you use to repair stuff that takes damage. It's relatively cheap. It's a whole lot cheaper than replacing a very expensive machine. And eventually you can build drones, and those drones can actually like grab and use repair packs to repair stuff automatically. Okay, I think I've fixed everything except this tree. This tree will heal itself.
What, Brownie? Why are you going close to the enemy base?
Oh, why are you here as well?
I'm looking out for you.
Okay.
Sus.
Why are you shooting your shotgun?
What?
So how do I select a gun anyway?
In the lower left panel. Does it actually work? I don't know. You're to parts of the game that I don't usually mess with. I almost never go on the offensive. I just build defensive stuff.
Rotating, through your gun inventory, I don't know how to do. I just reallocate stuff around.
How do I shoot my gun again?
Hold C and then holding down point and C. Click.
Yeah, I think if I remember correctly, point and click will let you fire at anything. I think holding down C will only shoot at something if there's actually something there to shoot.
Oh, God. What?
You guys are about to die, aren't you?
No, just Tanuki. And Sarah.
I can't figure out how to shoot. Come at me, mother. Help.
Watching from the safety of my turret.
Okay.
I can't figure out how do I shoot?
It's C, and then just like hovering the mouse over what you're trying to shoot at, or you can just like point and click, I believe.
I really wish you could.
You can go get your stuff here.
Can you? I didn't think you could.
Yeah, well, I could go to his body and click on it, and there's a bunch of stuff.
I wonder if that's something they added later, like after I started playing.
Or maybe in solo play,
the stuff's just lost forever. Interesting. Rest
my stuff.
Back up.
You dead?
Nope.
Oh, he dead.
Nope.
Huh. Dying gives me more ammo.
Technically, yes.
I wish there was a faster way to click and move things.
Okay, that could hurt.
Depending on what you're trying to do, there probably is. Are you trying to...
Moving shit from my body to...
Oh, if you shift-click on something, it moves it to whatever the other inventory you have open is. So like,
oh my god, that's exactly what I was looking for.
Yep, and you can use that on chests, you can use that on, like, when you're loading stuff into machines, you can use that basically anywhere.
I now need ammo for that gun. Okay, so I now have shotgun shells. My question is, how do we go up there and destroy that base?
Basically, you need overwhelming firepower. You effectively need to. Now, it only spawns dudes at a certain rate. So you can, like, overwhelm it.
Overwhelm it with our dead bodies.
What some people will do is they'll actually just, like, take some turrets up with them, and they'll just, like, basically plop down turrets and let the turrets try and blow them away. Also, with like three of you, you can probably run up and actually just gun them down as long as you, like, you know, hold your ground.
Okay, let's build some more shotgun shells in case of people like, yes, offensive.
Okay. Theoretically, let me think about this. Theoretically, what you could even do is you could have basically one person run in first to get their attention, because I want to say they won't switch their focus after they aggro on somebody.
No, I admit, I watched Brony run screaming by with like six of them and just looted my own body.
But in theory, what you could do is you could basically have one person run up, get their attention, run them down to the turrets where they die, and basically at that point, their base will be more or less undefended. And then the two people that are still up there can start gunning it down, and then the person who led them down could run back up and help out with blowing it up. That's a way you could do it as well.
I would suggest doing that in the morning, not right now.
Not in the middle of the night. I just want to check on how our coal production is doing. Okay, it looks like that's still good. One of the biggest dangers that can happen is if, like, let's say, for example, so right now our entire base is powered by coal. If all of a sudden we, like, our coal either isn't able to keep up, or, like, worst case scenario, one of our coal, like, our coal mining drill runs out of coal and we don't notice right away, all of a sudden, everything in your factory basically stops working. All the turrets, all the assembly machines, all the inserters, everything stops working. And the danger with that is that if you have a very large factory, once mm-hmm. that happens, it's actually very hard to get things back up and running again sometimes.
Well, I've got that research. Now we need
you. You almost have to shut down parts of your factory to
get pretty much, folks. Yeah. Yep. The nice thing about solar is that you don't have to worry about that so much, because unless something destroys your solar panels, or you destroy one of your power poles leading from the solar panels, the nice thing is that you don't generally have to worry about that, just because they don't require fuel, so it's not like mm-hmm. you're going to just suddenly run out of fuel.
So landfill is now being worked on. This one looks like it's going to take a minute.
A little bit. It's not a super long one, but I already have an inventory that's basically full of stone, so the moment we research it, I'm good to start building out.
Already researching.
That's yeah, but like the moment it finishes, I'm ready to start building it out. Because right now we're a little bit more exposed than I'd like to be personally, as far as our like main production and stuff.
Okay, so
as far as the way to get onto the peninsula, I'm going to build it 4 tiles wide. I'll build it 5 tiles wide. That's narrow enough that I can still easily put up the laser defenses and have them be effective. But also it's not so wide, or it's wide enough that we can get stuff to and from it fairly well, but it's narrow enough that I can still defend it with the laser turrets. Theoretically, there are flamethrower turrets. The only danger with using those for this kind of setup is that flamethrower turrets do set the ground and anything on the ground on fire, including things like your conveyor belts.
Oh.
Yeah. They're really great on the perimeter of your base. They're not as great...
the interior?
They're not as great if you need your belts to run past in front of them.
Hmm.
Those also require oil, which we're not to just yet. Although, really, at this point, we're not far off from needing oil. Or at least from being able to use oil.
Okay.
Let's see, I was going to drop this off. Where was I doing that? Here.
Okay.
Okay, let's see.
I need to step away for just a moment. I'm standing in what should be a safe place. I'll be right back.
Alright. It was fun, but a little closer to death than I really intended.
Okay, I'm back.
Welcome back.
Yay.
Okay. I think we're being attacked again.
Yep, from the north. Still nothing that did damage to us.
How's the south looking?
South pollution is getting close to those guys, so we're at the point where we're going to be concerned before too awful long.
I'm already concerned. Let's put it that way.
Well, I've already got by our stone mining, I have two turrets that are right there, and then I have the only downside is the area I'm standing in right now. There's a bit of a gap here. I do have one turret running. I do have one turret right here, and then I have this wall of turrets running. I do have this wall of turrets over here. I'm less concerned about the base that's going to attack us first. I'm more concerned with that one that's further off to the east. That's a much bigger base. But they won't be attacking us just yet.
That one in the corner?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm a little concerned with them too.
I mean, nothing that base is going to throw at us for the near future will break through this wall of turrets. But, I mean, every magazine of ammo we make does cost iron, so the biggest thing is we need to make sure we don't get overwhelmed with how much we can effectively afford to fight off.
Yeah.
Which is a concern that goes away once we hit laser turrets, but yep. The hard part is that as we get stronger, so do the aliens. So,
really,
yep. Right now, we're only fighting what are called small, like small biters and small spitters and stuff. Eventually, we're going to be hitting medium and then large, and if we're going for a very long time, behemoth.
We could totally take a couple of those right now.
Every level is something like between 4 and 16 times stronger than the next smaller level.
I think
behemoths have... I feel like behemoths are actually a much bigger jump even. I feel like behemoths are like 64 times the amount that a large has.
We could take it, come on.
Oh, it is possible to fight them off. I mean, they solely exist as a challenge for people that are playing, like, super late game with mega bases and things like that. The hardest part with those, actually, isn't even so much their hit points or the amount of damage they do. The hardest part with them is that their range is longer. It's still shorter than the range on a laser turret, but not by much.
Come on, Landfill, hurry up. We need you, and then... Oh, I should get something to drink. I am out of drink.
Research beverages.
Yeah, let's see here. Landfill is about to get done. What do I want next? I know there's mention of wanting cars. I don't even know why I need to have cars.
Cars basically, yeah.
What does that actually need? Logistics and engines. Okay, I'll take note of that. Noted.
That's just to build them.
Yeah. What do we need to have built? Solar power is on an agenda because reducing our pollution is good.
Yep.
Reducing pollution is good, but we also need advanced material processing. Automation 2 would probably help.
Actually, I'm kind of surprised automobilism only requires red and green science. I wonder if it used to require a blue, but they changed it.
Oh, my fucking knee. Probably go with automation 2. That looks quick. Once we're done. Automation 2 looks like it's nice and quick.
All right. Automation 2 is also required later on. We will need automation 2 because so in addition to being able to run faster, the assembly machines you get from automation 2 and automation 3 can actually handle fluid ingredients, which the like tier ones that we have right here can't do. Yeah.
What do you recommend, though?
If it was me, I would probably hold off on logistics, or not logistics. I would probably hold off on production or
automation.
Automation. I'd probably hold off on automation 2 just yet, because our machines can already keep up with our labs. If it was me, I would probably go with what would I go with here? I'd be tempted to start working toward either oil production or laser turrets.
Laser turrets needs solar energy.
Yeah.
You know what? That's going to take forever. Let's do it. Because, again, it's going to take forever. I'd rather get the big one out of the way. Getting that one out of the way, the big one is started. It will also reduce pollution.
Actually, strictly speaking, laser turrets actually don't require solar. I just like to use them with solar.
Well, no. I also think having solar energy and batteries is a good idea because it will reduce that pollution cloud, which will not have the dudes as pissy with us. And
true. All right, I think I see the direction I'm going to build the peninsula in, so.
Okay, and I need these.
Actually, it probably makes the most sense to build it from here.
There we go. Just took a bunch of stuff. Just gobble, gobble, gobble.
Nah.
I've stopped getting gears. What happened?
I'm updating stuff. So. If I should have it all fixed.
Updates.
I should have it all fixed before it's too much of an issue.
Now, one interesting thing, too, is you remember how the oil patch was in this kind of awkward, annoying to get to place?
Yeah.
Well, the nice thing with building this artificial peninsula is I'd want to do some scouting over there just to make sure that, because I feel like that's an island up there that it's on, but I can't say for sure without like somebody revealing that part of the map. As long as that is an island, we can actually just safely, I can just build over to that and then, hey, cool, we have oil right here, like on site. If it's not like if it's not an island and it actually is part of the mainland, then we won't be able to do that, but we can still actually make it pretty convenient to get to. So So I'm really hoping that's an island.
Yeah. Island would be nice. Okay, what are you looking at? One green? No. Give more green. Give more green. Yeah, I'm gonna go get something to drink. Be right back.
Okay.
Yeah, on mine it says you're being disconnected for or being dropped from the game. If you want, I can send you another to get back in. All right, let me send an invite.
Hello?
Hello?
Oh, there we go. I'm reconnecting.
Are you reconnecting?
Yeah, okay. My internet crashed.
Okay.
All right. Do you need a fresh invite to get back?
Yeah.
Right. Invite coming.
Here, nothing. Dead.
Okay, what's your problem here?
Let me know when you send it.
It should already be sent.
Oh, there I see. Okay, there we go. Connection to game.
All right. There we go. So yeah, I was saying that I need a lot of stone to make landfill.
Yeah.
Every tile worth of ground that I create needs 20 stone to make it, which is why I need so much.
That's what happened with the green.
Why is there random red science on this belt?
Don't worry about it.
What?
You know what? I'm going to call that not my problem. It's not my department. Sir Noble, are you still there?
Yeah.
Okay. I just saw your Discord message asking if we could hear you.
What the fuck is the mystery of red science?
I assume it's Brony's doing. He's clearly an imposter, sabotaging from within.
Let's see.
Yeah, I know I want to go at least as high as high enough to absorb these islands here. The problem is if I accidentally make a bridge to land, like to the mainland, I basically have to either start this all over again or I have to accept, okay, now I have two places I need to guard.
That doesn't sound like a good thing.
Not ideal. Okay, I see the oil patch. That looks an awful lot like an island. So let me just scooch over here a little bit. Yeah, that's actually an island. So I'm going to go ahead and build to that. And I'll just sort of absorb that into our, like, peninsula of safety.
Okay.
So that actually is going to be phenomenal for us because it means that we have a safe, well, we will have a fully safe and secure source of effectively infinite fuel blocks. Meaning that I can actually safely use fuel blocks instead of solar, which is going to save a whole ton of space on the laser power setup.
Interesting.
Yep. Is the downside of solar, and this doesn't matter for like peaceful playthroughs without any aliens. But the downside with solar is that it requires, which means you need to defend a huge amount of space. That's like one of the key advantages of nuclear power is the amount of power you can produce in a given space. And by the way, without mods, nuclear reactors cannot melt down in Factorio.
Yay.
There are mods that add that, but in the base game, it
Oh.
cannot.
Bad mods.
Okay, how are things going here? Cool, we go.
Fine, I keep getting mystery red shit.
Oh, yeah, don't worry about that.
What are you planning?
I'm planning nothing.
He has no plan. That's why we're getting the red science up here.
That's what I wanted.
Has that just been swiping them and shoveling them in because I got a.
I've
Okay.
just been swiping them and drinking them because they look like cherry Kool-Aid. Okay, after scouting this little island out, we actually have two oil patches on this island. Which is even better because it means in theory I could have one that's just dedicated to producing fuel blocks to power the laser turrets for safety.
Okay.
For
For some
safety.
reason, you're not passing off your fucking equipment. You're making me irritable. Little shit. Oh, that's
Hi,
probably why.
Lauren. Lower.
Tiny conveyor. I'm used to
Oh,
big
sorry, I just got my
conveyors.
stuff up. Was it considerably worth hitting automation too earlier? Entities, pollution statistics are given units per minute. Boiler systems.
That is a good point,
Just,
actually. Yeah.
yeah.
The
So.
one of the one of his viewers is talking about an advantage of automation too is that per product produced, they're actually more efficient and less pollution than the tier one factories or
Yeah.
assembly machines, rather.
Yeah.
That's it. That is a good point. I will. Think after solar
Yeah.
power,
Players can walk over
that
one
might be.
tile of water, but miners can't. With the right design, you don't need to defend solar fields.
Oh,
Oven.
that's something I didn't know, actually. I knew players could step over one tile. I don't play with the I don't play with the aliens on very often, so a lot of the combat and alien mechanics I'm not nearly as familiar with. So, thanks. That's awesome to know.
Yep. Okay. And yeah.
Okay.
I just have to watch the chaos over here with the mysterious red science.
I don't know what he's doing. He's
I know what he's doing, or at least
Yeah,
I don't know why. I know the what, but not the why.
he's. I had a factory here specifically for to make my red science.
so Well, I was like, here's my thought process. So, okay, we need to get, you know, copper panels up there to make the red signs. And the belt is already full of coal and gears. So I need to run another belt all the way up there to deliver copper plates. That's dumb. Why don't I just make the red signs down here and then send that up? And then we don't have to worry about cogs and plates.
Because I also need copper plates for everything up there, including the, what the hell is it called? I need copper plates for the green shit.
Somebody's about to get attacked. I just saw a swarm of biters go down. I think they're just going down to the base.
Yep, here they come.
Oh, fuzzy shit.
All right, I'm going to build this far.
But I need copper for... You see the five factories up there?
I saw them, yep.
Those are for the green alone.
Okay.
So
we'll need to deal with that. Good to know.
Yeah. The green requires factory empty, copper plates. The problem is it needs a shitload of copper wire.
Yep.
So you need plates also, or wires?
I need more gears than you.
Also, technically speaking, the artificial peninsula I'm building, the safe place effectively, eventually we're probably, not strictly required, but I would highly recommend basically moving our actual, like, not resource gathering, but factory portion of our base up to that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Resource gathering obviously has to go where the resources are.
So I need... Okay, where the hell is the frickin' iron plate? Just take a bunch. I need a bunch. Okay. So go back up there. In fact, do my favorite thing and super run along the conveyor, stealing everything on it. No. You have a good amount of shit. You need more plates. You already need more plates. Holy hell. Copper wire is frickin' hungry.
Yep. Copper wire is very fast, and each plate makes two wires. However, the green circuits each need three wires. So you will go through quite a lot of copper.
Okay, so kick those like that whole stack of conveyor belts just to keep things moving into you.
This actually works out quite nice because it gives me a vantage point of the base that's directly to our north.
Okay.
By the way, when you guys do eventually go to try and assault the base, they have two.
You are being.
Yeah, they have two small worms.
Just don't give a shit.
Actually, I'm running around with a whole bunch of transport belts. Tanuki, I'll throw those in the machinery on the way.
Uh-huh. Okay, let's get some green science into that third one that's appeared.
Okay, so...
Okay, what's the problem? Why aren't you producing...
I miss my solo playthrough where I have power armor that lets me run like 3 times this fast.
Yeah, understandable. Okay. Kind of having to babysit these machines is a pain in my ass.
That's why you generally want to get away from manual, like, hand-feeding stuff.
I'm trying not to. I'm trying to get it so they all do it automatically.
Yeah, but yeah. The
problem is they start stopping for one reason, because one thing gets full, so I have to declog. Well,
something getting full isn't a problem.
I like constant production.
Well, factory is only going to move at the speed of the slowest piece that it needs. By the way, I am noticing that we're running low on power again, so I'm going to go ahead
You can fix the power down here because it's kind of a mess.
Oh, it's not the number of power lines. We're not actually producing as much power as our machines want. So I'm just going to up our power production a little bit.
Well, a couple new labs have appeared.
Yep.
Which is probably not helping.
Yeah, but no big.
Sounds like we're making meth or something.
I mean, what do you think the science is for?
Rocket ships to get us out of here?
Sorta. Technically, yes, actually. All right, I'll build us 2 more steam engines.
Okay.
Okay, I think I have enough red. I think I'm making enough red at the moment. Let me know if that's not true.
You're making enough red to keep up with something like maybe a dozen labs right now.
Okay. Let's see. Building stepping stone bridges with landfill is useful right because now, it makes areas.
The thing is the green.
Okay, new power is coming online in just a moment. Just need to run a pipe here.
All right. Thanks, Lauren.
There we go.
Vanilla reactors don't melt down. We are working towards that, so.
Melting down?
Yeah, it says vanilla reactors don't melt down, which you mentioned just before they started on there, so.
Oh, yep. Yeah.
Okay.
You
know, I could actually.
It was actually one thing I really enjoyed when we used to play when we were playing Minecraft all those years ago, and we were doing Tekkit.
Yep.
I actually liked that those reactors did have the meltdown risk.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yeah. I mean, I built safe ones, but it was kind of fun because it was that extra bit of challenge of like, you know, this could annihilate my entire sky castle if I screw this up. I actually like that danger.
And let's see.
Oh yeah, I was going to drop stuff off on my way through here and never did.
Oh, that's the initial reason I went up there.
Yeah, strictly speaking, there is a ratio of machines where if you build everything in exactly that ratio and nothing at all throws off that balance, there is a ratio of machines that will produce basically everything is running at exactly the same speed as everything else. So you're producing... Mm-hmm. Exactly the right amount of this, exactly the right amount of this, etc. That's actually completely unachievable with aliens, though, because the alien attacks use a variable amount of, you know, bullets to take out and things like that.
Okay, so what am I going to need to get the turrets we want? Okay, let's plan this sucker out. I need automation too. Yeah, I also need military one, because I need to be able to build a black science.
Oh yeah, black science is ridiculously iron intensive, so be prepared.
I'm not planning on utilizing it yet, but we are one research away from it, and it is a requirement of the lasers.
Yep.
But the second path I'm seeing here is huge. We need automation 2, and we need engines, which unlocks fluid handling, which then goes into oil processing, and we need sulfur and plastics, which... Yep. Then into advanced electronics and batteries, which goes into blue science.
This is where the game starts spiraling into madness, because this is where you get the this is where you start dealing with the oil processing.
And then we, from the blue and the optics, we get lasers, which then lasers and the black science goes into laser turrets.
Yep. And the black science is also needed for more of our high-end weaponry and things like that.
So for now, I'm thinking automation 2 for pollution worries. We'll hit that. Engines, and then maybe military 2.
Sounds good. We actually also need the black science for tanks anyway, so that is also helpful.
Just
we got attacked again, looks like. Oh, something got damaged, so their attacks are getting more effective. If somebody wants to repair that as well.
How do you
repair otherwise it? I have a what was that?
How do you repair it?
So do you remember before I was talking about those repair packs?
Not off the top of my
head. Okay, if not, if you go under the production tab in crafting, there's the thing that looks like a wrench and a screwdriver up at the top. That's a repair pack. You can build one of those. And if you basically just left click and hold it on whatever you want to repair, it'll repair.
Gotcha.
You can eventually build drones that do all the repairs for you. But we're if we want to go the drone route, we are a very, 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 very long way away from that.
I don't know what route we're going. I'm just going, okay, we want, this was mentioned. How do I get to this? I do this. Okay, good. That's my plot line until further notice.
Yep.
I'm a simple creature. I get told goal. I look into goal.
And goal, commit violence. Oh. Okay, that's as far south as I want that to go.
All right. It's probably not. Okay, let's see. And
also, something kind of important to be aware of is if you look at the map, you see we have those patches of iron, coal, copper, stone, like conveniently right there.
Yeah.
When those patches deplete, look how far away the next patches of things are. Oh. Just something to be aware of.
I know. It's a ways.
Yep.
And
yeah, right now we're playing on all default settings. A lot of times, like I think when we've played in the past, a lot of times we bump up the resource availability. But it's like, yeah, let's get the default. What happened to this belt here?
There was a lot of bugs right in front of this turret that was damaged.
Yeah. I have additional concerns about this belt.
Which belt is that?
The one that has a mix of red science and copper wire on it, kind of interwoven with each other.
Yeah, don't worry about that. It'll sort itself out, I'm sure.
What the hell is going on down here?
Well, you said you wanted
basically copper wire. Basically what I was wondering.
You said you wanted copper wire, so I started doing that. And then it's like, oh, yeah, I should probably, you know, bring in this second belt at some point. So I started doing that.
I have a factory building copper wire. Catch about that is it takes like 3 factories to actually.
Mm-hmm.
This whole setup is just for this whole 5 factory setup is for green science, and automating it is a complete and utter whore.
I feel like Brony has just sort of decided he's going to build a sushi belt factory. Which, they're fascinating. They don't work well, but they're fascinating to watch.
If that's what he wants to do.
It gives me stuff to do, I'll say that. Whether that's the stuff that I should be doing or not is another question
entirely. Our iron situation has sorted itself out. It's a bit of a mess, but it's sorted.
Yay!
Because I'm all about efficiency. I'm looking at this going, how do I make it better? How do I make this streamlined?
I'm a coordinator by trade. I'm not going to streamline as a hobby.
I do. That's because I'm a little on the crazy side.
I'm going to go this far north of here. I'm trying to make the peninsula big enough that it's like an effective factory size for when we relocate to it.
Okay, it's building slowly. I hate to say this, but... Well, actually, if I'm manually doing this, at the speed it runs, I have ideas. Okay, da-da-da-da-da. Assembly. I want one more assembly machine.
Let's do that, and let's
get off my island tree. This is my island now. No trees.
Okay, so... Cogs, those I need.
Second factory for science, and I can just
belt hurts me at a very deep spiritual level. I'm just putting that out there.
Look, I'm not the one doing this to you.
Oh, no. I was standing next to the one doing this.
For new players to boost riches by default settings. Main benefit of default settings is that they're easier to communicate and compare. Describe Factorio as crafting animation and logistics game with light survival and tower defense elements.
Yeah.
We're playing on default because I want them to suffer. That's kind of what the gist is here.
Why would you do that to us?
Because I said I wanted to play on default and nobody told me no. The first game I ever played was on default. It is very doable, but...
okay. I have a second small... It's a hand-fed factory because everything keeps stopping due to overproduction. Oh, God, something's damaged.
We're taking... okay, one of our power poles just got damaged. Okay, that's an attack from the south. Stuff's getting destroyed. Are they still attacking?
It must be because I just lost all power down here.
Yeah. Well, if they knocked out a power pole, that'll do it. All right, let me beef up stuff down here.
I'm heading on down to take a look.
They probably went around the turrets that were down here.
This way? Yeah, there's one over here that died. So...
Let me donate one of the turrets from this turret wall over here, because this doesn't need this many.
We're up online again.
Yep.
We're online again.
All right. So they attacked kind of like this little branch here or up here?
There's one dead one like right here, right where I
stand. Oh, I see. All right. So in that case, I'm going to just go ahead and plop this maybe here. I don't know what's most convenient for you to extend the ammo belt here for.
Well, I haven't extended it yet anyways, so...
Ah, okay.
But extending it is something I should probably look into.
Yep.
So what was I looking at? I was looking at...
Right. I'm just kind of boxing in the area that's going to be our peninsula, and then I'll actually fill everything in. I find if I don't do that, I tend to go too far, and I end up getting close enough to the mainland that stuff can reach to it, like the spitters can reach to attack us. And that's not pleasant.
I have comments. They're not safe for people under the age of 18. I am refraining.
Yeah, giddy.
You can thank me later.
I could, but will I?
Actually going to be a slight problem.
Ah, shit, fuck, damn, I just stole a chest and all its contents.
You'll never catch me alive.
Okay, I put the chest back. Hopefully the thing starts working on it, and yeah, here's hoping I didn't fuck something up. Oops.
Ed.
I'm looking for plates. I need an ass ton of these things.
What type of steel or
iron?
Yeah. So yeah, that would be over here. Here's the chest that we have them all in.
This is the descent into madness I was hoping for. By the way, we're getting attacked again.
Oh, yeah, up here.
I need power armor that runs like lightning so I can get there and shoot. We have destruction.
A little bit. We have some damage. They made it to one of the turrets.
I took care of it.
Yeah, we're getting close to where we probably want to deal with that base.
Yeah, no, I'm starting to think building an ass ton of shotgun ammo and actually, can I build a turret?
Yep, you should be able to build a turret. Turrets just need, like, what is it, 40 iron and 10 copper? Something like that.
I have a lot of shit on me. I'm building me a turret. Because you mentioned the strategy of just, you know...
block turrets down?
Yeah.
Yep.
Why it's the actually hell
a pretty...
Why the hell do I have, like... an unholy level of bullets?
How many were in the chest you accidentally disassembled?
Oh. Oh, shit, that would explain a lot.
Yeah, and if I remember correctly, bullets stacked to 200.
I have like
200 magazines.
I have a couple of stacks.
Yeah, that would do it.
You need a little bit.
Okay, and
all right, construction's been going nicely up here.
Okay.
I still need to actually build the kill zone.
So I've got
being attacked. Looks like they did not punch through this time. The waves they're sending at us are definitely getting bigger, though.
Yeah, had something to do with that.
There. Okay, got that thing back producing again, so I can keep moving shit around here. You need another load of those, so we're giving you another load of those.
Like we're still okay on power so far.
Okay. So after solar energy automation was brought up to actually produce less pollution, which will help us in the long run, so I think going for that.
Yep. Just as a question, how much longer are we going to go tonight?
I don't know. I'm good with whatever, really.
Yeah, I'm ready for stopping whenever.
Should we call it here in the next few minutes? Or?
I should probably get some sleep.
Yeah, it works for me. All right, I'm at a good point whenever.
So am I.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and close down then.
Okay.
Save. Sounds good. All right. And quit.
Yeah, well, thanks everyone for watching. Thanks everyone in chat for help and the suggestions. So found that real helpful.
Thank you.
I learned a few new things today.
All right, so, and with that, we'll catch you all next time.